My loneliness is killing me.
And I
must confess, I still believe. When I'm not with you, I lose my mind. Give me a sign. Hit me, baby, one more time.
Do you find it hard to deal with the fame part of it? Are you able to go out in the street or everyone knows it's you?
Sometimes. I'm just now starting to get, you'll go into a store and people will be, asking you for your autograph and stuff. But it's flattering to me. I think it's really sweet.
Yeah, well, you're a level-headed young girl, and I hope that you stay that way, and I think that you will. Stay there in Louisiana. It's a nice place, and it'll keep you grounded.
What do you think it'll take to get the paparazzi to leave you alone?
I don't know.
Why are you crying, Brittany?
You okay, Brittany?
Are you okay, Brittany?
Brittany, I love your hat.
Please go away.
Is that one of your biggest wishes?
Okay. I would like to enjoy family.
Britney Spears is one of the most successful stars on the planet, with some of the biggest songs and music videos of all time. She has gone down as one of the most iconic performers of the 21st century, securing herself as a legend within pop culture. It's not news to anyone that fame and success bring with it a lot of pressure. And it seems the greater the success, the greater the strain. So when someone finds themselves a megastar at 17 years old, maybe the most visible megastar on the planet, it's no surprise to see them rise and fall. It's what we do. We raise a humble human to the status of God, then smash them down again, just to prove that they're mortal. In our secular society, we fill the godless gap with celebrity, and we take pleasure in cheering on the underdog until they're not the underdog anymore. Then we destroy them. I've been a fan of Britney Spears since Baby One More Time in 1998. The Oops I Did It Again single was the first CD that I ever had, and her Oops I Did It Again tour was the first time I ever went to a live concert. I just remember so clearly watching in awe as she performed hit after hit. I've always been fascinated by her story, from humble beginnings to being cast in the Mickey Mouse Club with the likes of Christina Aguilera, Ryan Gosling, and of course, Justin Timberlake.
Dale.
Jennifer.
Justin.
Carrie.
JC.
Britney.
As we all know, Britney and Justin entered into one of the most high-profile relationships in show business. But it wasn't meant to be. In a post on social media in 2020, Britney herself referred to it as one of the world's biggest breakups. And she wasn't wrong. The breakup led on to one of Justin's greatest hits. With a Britney lookalike in the music video, it was pretty clear what Justin was alluding to. That Britney had been unfaithful. It was like Britney had become a prisoner, unable to do anything for fear of being hounded by the paparazzi. That whole cliche of pop star hounded by the press, I think actually makes it really difficult to appreciate just how oppressive and claustrophobic this lifestyle must really be. And I think it's so easy to forget that at the center of it all is just this human, no different from any of us, just trying to get through life.
How does your mom, when she knows that you're going through some things and you know, the things mm-hmm. that you've talked about that have been tough, which I think you've handled very well, mm-hmm. but how does she play as far as the support?
She's amazing. She is awesome.
Thanks, Mom, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, this is the toughest question I'm going to ask you, if anybody does want to know the answer to it. Ben or Brad? Because you know what? You told me Ben.
I did?
Like, you got emotional about your mom.
I did. Ew. Stupid.
No, it's not. My mom is here, and I would be doing the same thing. Because my mom gets me through everything, too, so you can just make me cry with you. She's a good one, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Special.
No matter how big your mansion is, this level of scrutiny and attention is a massive price to pay. As the years went on, it was clear that this young woman was not coping, and yet we couldn't take our eyes off it.
I know it's not, but I just want to listen for you. You cannot say yes or no?
I remember waking up to the news that pop superstar Britney Spears had shaved her head. From today's narrative around matters of mental health, it's so clear to see that it was a cry for help, a symptom of illness. But to a great extent, this wasn't reported as a young woman's battle with mental health. It was more like a comical mishap, a wacky celebrity has lost the plot.
All right, sounds good, thank you, bro.
Look.
Even stranger then, it was the leading headline story on the television news.
Oh my God.
Not politics, war, famine, the economy. The breaking news that day was the psychological breakdown of a mother of two.
Britney Spears. She's bald.
As erratic as Britney Spears' behavior has been lately, this really, I think, caught everyone off guard. Kelly Clarkson was at the Daytona 500 this weekend. This is her reaction as she learns the shocking news.
Kelly, Britney Spears has shaved her head.
Okay, are y'all kidding? Because somebody just told me that out there, and I think that's a joke.
Is that a style that you would ever consider for
she
yourself?
She did not shave
she
her
did.
Head. Are you for real?
Absolutely.
There's only 3 months age difference between you and Britney.
Absolutely.
And look at the difference. Complete disaster.
Fuck you! Fuck yourself!
Well, I mean, people handle different things differently, and thank God I've been, you know,
surrounded by honesty, and thank God I've chosen to still be around people that I trust.
They asked why she wanted to shave her head, and she said, I don't want anyone touching me. I'm tired of everybody touching me.
If you're looking for trouble, you can be like this.
Dark enough that a personal trauma was playing out on the public stage, but even more sick I felt that the cause of her distress, the media circus, was now reaping the rewards of the damage it had so clearly contributed to.
This performance was particularly painful for Britney Spears.
Britney seemed nervous, the MTV Music Awards, in a time so out of it that you wondered if she knew where she was or if she knew the words to her own song.
She looked downright out of it. I mean, this is somebody who perhaps you may have questioned whether or not she had the best voice in the world. She was known for being an entertainer and for being able to dance. And she's literally being directed and shuffled around the stage by the backup dancers. I mean,
she was just admitted for chemical dependency, so she's an addict. There's speculation about postpartum depression. There's been bizarre behaviors. You have somebody who is in serious, serious medical trouble psychiatrically.
How did the people around her allow this to happen last night? Why didn't someone say, hey, you're not ready to perform? What does she pay these people to do?
This is a story about a girl named Becky.
Early morning, she wakes up. Knock, knock, knock on the door. It's time for makeup.
Whilst I was researching for this video, I noticed that there's a particular narrative that plays out with women of great celebrity. There are certain roles that we as a society force high-profile females to inhabit. Firstly, we buy into them as this young maiden. you know, the virginal sweetheart that captures the public's imagination. And then, when they stray away from that image of innocence, they become the whore. This is when all criticism and mockery becomes fair game. And after that, when the punishment goes too far, they reach their final role as the angel. They gain icon status, often as a symbol of suffering that lives on, glorified in our memories. This whole narrative unsurprisingly gets dictated to us by those who deal in newspaper sales, viewer ratings, and online clicks. We lap it up, so they churn it out. And in 2007, this was a time when the press had more power in constructing the public imagination than it does today. But now, in the age of being famous for being famous, social media gives those with a public profile a direct route to the public, with whatever filter or spin they decide to put on it. But for Britney, this immediate relationship with her followers doesn't seem to have brought her control over the narrative. Her social media posts seem only to fuel ongoing speculation about her mental health, her personal life, and her career decisions.
Casually revealed that she burnt down her home gym.
Hi guys, I'm in my gym right now. I haven't been in here for like 6 months because I burnt my gym down, unfortunately. I had two candles and yeah, one thing led to another and I burnt it down.
A lot to get to. Britney Spears, everyone. You know, her fans have launched this Free Britney campaign, and they believe, the fans do, that she's being held in a mental facility against her will.
A growing number of Britney fans around the world are convinced that she needs freeing from her conservatorship, which gave her father control over her finances and personal decisions in 2008 due to her state of mind.
Nobody works for her for free. They work because they get a percentage of what she earns. So when there's a lot of money involved, nothing would surprise me. Yeah. I know.
Yes, it's possible that Britney Spears is trapped in some exploitative situation, but I wouldn't know. But it strikes me that the speculation, rumours, conspiracies and gossip are what played such a big part in Britney's descent into illness.
Fans want to know, Britney, are you okay?
You could say that this film is an exercise in hypocrisy. And by talking about it at all, maybe I'm part of the problem. But my message isn't simply leave Britney alone. That's been done before. It's to think about how what we consume as fans leads to the downfall of these people that we admire. And to better understand when the fascination with one's personal life goes beyond reasonable public interest. Looking back, it's clear to see that a line was crossed when it comes to the personal life of Britney Spears. I just hope that we've evolved as a society, and when we see a high-profile figure in their darkest moments, we can recognise their humanity over the icon. Let's stop making angels out of humans we admire.